FLM has sent me another tripod. This is the Berlin. This thing is a monster. And in this video, we're going to take a closer look at this really cool tripod. So earlier this year, I reviewed the travel tripod from FLM. I liked it so much that I purchased it. And because I liked it so much, they sent me this one to test out. Didn't buy this one yet. But this is the FLM Berlin. As you can tell, this thing is a beast. This top spider plate is probably the largest I've ever seen on a tripod. It absolutely dwarfs my Really Ride Stuff 3-4L. It's got a much wider top base here. This is a carbon fiber tripod, but one of the things that's kind of unique about FLM tripods is that the locking grips are actually made of metal. Just like on their Travel Series tripod, opens up very easily, very smoothly, and it's not even an eighth of a turn before you unlock these legs. This tripod is not the tallest tripod in the world. I'm 5'9", and it gets right about at eye level. If I was to put a ball head on it, put a camera on it, it's gonna be right about eye level. Has a bubble level on the base, which is very, very important if you do any kind of panoramas. Another thing that they've done that I really like is kind of like the Enduro series. They've made this top plate easily removable with just a single Allen wrench. And you can replace this flat base with a video bowl, so you could put a fluid video head on here as well and then swap it out and use this as a video tripod as well. The tubing on this is absolutely massive, as is this piece here. Just like their Travel Series tripod, the way the locking mechanisms work is you can full press it, it goes all the way up to the top, press it back down, then it'll ratchet into place. Or you can half press it, and then it'll go into the next slot. I like this locking mechanism. I have no idea how it's going to last over time. I've been burnt with locking mechanisms before, like on the Fizol, but I think this is going to last pretty well, although I do wish that it was spring-loaded, that way it would automatically go down into place, so it'd ratchet back into place. This tripod is all about just stability. This thing is an absolute beast. And I love how minimalistic it is in a way. Like there's no bells and whistles, there's no center column. I hate center columns. There's just a nice flat base, very simple locking mechanisms. It's just kind of bare bones, but it's all about stability. The bigger that this plate is, the wider the stance is, the more stability you're gonna have. And when you couple that with really large and really rigid carbon fiber tubing, you're gonna have a very, very stable platform. I think that this tripod is going to be excellent for anybody that uses long lenses, maybe a big gimbal, or you just shoot in windy conditions or in water, you know, rushing water. Anytime you need just absolute stability, this tripod is going to be excellent. It is not the lightest tripod. When it's folded up, it feels very, very dense. My Really Ride Stuff tripod is not a light tripod. I have the 3-4L, and I've always kind of considered that a beast, but this particular tripod is actually a little bit heavier than that. This tripod is not going to be great for the person that hikes a lot or travels nonstop. If you're willing to pack just a little bit of extra weight, you are going to get a whole lot of extra stability. I like that it folds up so short, although another concern that I do have is that when I fly with my tripod, a lot of times I mount it to the side of my bag, and then when I put it in an overhead compartment, I'm worried that its width is going to restrict some of the doors, you know, in the overhead compartment from closing. So you might have to take this off and take this as your second carry-on and put it underneath your seat, which you're totally allowed to do. FLM has included built-in spikes. So if we unthread this, it's got this built-in spike with a metal tip, and then you just thread this on. I'm not sure that I love this configuration because I like really long spikes, and I like the ability to add accessories to add to my tripod. And there's kind of a standard with Gitzo and Enduro and Really Ride Stuff. They all take a 3/8 thread where you can add really long spikes. Maybe you want to add rock grabbers, but with this, you're left with these two options and that's it. Having said that, I think they'll get the job done, but there would be times like when I'm shooting on a beach that I'd like to have a nice long spike. Now, comparing it to a couple other tripods, here we have the FLM. You can see the size of this particular top plate. Here's the Really Ride Stuff. If you compare the two, you can see that the FLM is much, much larger. It's going to give it a lot of stability, but it's also going to just take up more room on the side of your bag, but you're gonna have a huge stability benefit. Here we have it next to the Faisal 3472. And you can see again, it's even larger than this, which also has a nice large plate. There's going to be a huge benefit as far as stability on this FLM. Now if we take a look at the length when it's folded up, you can see that the Faisal may be a tiniest bit shorter, which is really nice when you're traveling because you're not dealing with a long tripod. The Really Ride stuff, they call it a 3-4L for a reason. It's very long, but you get the added benefit of a really tall tripod when you need that. This is what the top plate looks like with no ball head. You can see that it has cork. This top plate is so massive that it doesn't matter what ball head you're gonna put on there. They're all going to look kind of puny. Here is a BH55, which is a monstrous ball head. It's a huge ball head, but you can see that there's lots of room to spare on that top plate. Here's what it looks like with the GP ball head on it. You can see that it looks just positively cute. This top plate is massive, but that's also where you're gonna get all your stability. And I think that's probably the biggest benefit of this particular tripod is all of that stability you're gaining from this top plate. So as far as my final thoughts about this tripod, let's start with the pros. This thing is an absolute beast. It's going to be incredibly stable. One of the things I like about it is that it's just no frills. It's just simple and effective. I love tripods with no center column. There's not a whole lot to go wrong on this tripod. It folds down nice and short. Like I've said a bunch of times, this is just going to be incredibly stable. This is going to be an excellent tripod for anybody that uses long telephoto lenses, big gimbals, heavier setups. This thing is an absolute beast and it's going to give you all the stability that you could possibly get. I also like the leg locks, like all of their tripods. They're metal, they work really smooth. They're gonna be incredibly easy to clean because the way that the sleeves are on the inside are very simple, very clean. It's just a very simple, effective setup. Okay, so as far as cons, this is not a very light tripod. This is a fairly heavy tripod. It's a little bit heavier than my Really Ride stuff, which I already thought was a little bit on the heavy side. The carbon fiber helps it, but all of this metal up on top, it makes it fairly heavy. So if you're somebody that doesn't mind a heavy tripod or somebody that's not hiking a long distance, you're not gonna be bothered by it. But if you're a hiker and you're hiking miles into a place, this thing is gonna weigh you down a little bit. Also, I worry about the very thing that I love about it is the fact that it's wide at the top, but this wide top is going to pose a little bit of a problem when you're flying because you mount it to the side of your bag, you put it in the overhead compartment, and it's gonna have a lot of width to it. So I worry a little bit about that, but I'm sure on larger flights, it's not gonna be a big issue. Also, I'm not a fan of the way that they've implemented the removable feet. I think that this setup is fine, but I'd much prefer to just see a standard 3/8 thread here where I could choose my own spikes and choose my own feet. With this, you're kind of stuck with the two that they give you. So I'm not a huge fan of this. So my final thoughts are, this is an amazing tripod, especially when you consider the price. This tripod's gonna be selling between $750 and $800, which is not cheap, but for the amount of stability you're getting, if you compare that to the Gitzo or the Really Ride Stuff alternatives, this is going to be hundreds of dollars cheaper than the Series 4 of those two different tripod manufacturers. So this is going to be a great bargain for the amount of stability you're getting, and it is a whole lot of stability. I should mention that this is an Indiegogo campaign where it actually closes on Friday. And on Friday, you can get this for, I believe, under $600. Once it hits retail, it's going to be selling for several hundred dollars more. So if you want to pick up this tripod and you want to get it at a bargain price, hit the links in the show notes below and you can get this for several hundred dollars less. Thank you to FLM for sending me this tripod, and hopefully this has been interesting to you, and we'll see you in the next video. I'm freezing and I'm gonna go warm up. Bye-bye.